Okay, we have now an example of an unsteady state mass balance. That means a balance which is time dependent. Well, we take the example of the previous time. We take a vessel with an initial concentration of salt in it, which is well mixed. So that means that the concentration on each place is similar. We have an inflow, a volume flow rate inflow with a concentration of salt in the inlet. And at the outlet, we have the same amount, only with a concentration in the outlet. Because the vessel is well mixed, we assume that the outlet concentration is equivalent to the concentration in the vessel. Well, how do we solve this problem? Well, first we have set up the mass balance over the salt in the vessel. Let's start. The change of the salt as a function of time is equal to the volume flow rate multiplied by the concentration in the inlet minus the volume flow rate multiplied by the concentration in the outlet. Well, we have seen that the concentration in the vessel and in the outlet are similar. So, what is the mass which is here? Well, this term is the concentration in the vessel multiplied by the volume of the vessel, and that is the volume in which the salt is dissolved, as a function of time, and that's also equal to, well, let's put this in the brackets, C is in, minus the concentration, C is out. Well, we have now a differential equation here, and we have to solve this one. Well, let's do this step by step. Well, first of all, the change of concentration as a time is equal to the volume flow rate divided by the volume minus the concentration at the inlet min the concentration in the outlet, which is similar to the concentration in the vessel. So in the rest of this equation, we will put Cs. Why is it allowed to get the V outside this term and Cs not? Well, Cs is dependent on the time, and the volume is constant. So constants may be taken outside, and we divide the whole equation. Well, now we have to separate the variables. So at this side, we write down Cs divided by Cs in minus C salt is equal to the volume flow rate divided by the volume multiplied by dt. Well, to integrate these two sides, we need here the same variable as below the line. So we rewrite this in Cs in minus Cs divided by Cs in minus Cs. But in this case, we have introduced a minus. So we have to put a minus in this equation, and we put this on the right side. So in this case, we get dt. In this case, we have to integrate both sides and to solve this. Well, we solve this between t is 0 and a certain t. Let's say t is t. And the concentration initially in the vessel till a concentration at a certain time, let's say ct. Well, now we have to integrate this equation, and what we then get is the logarithm of Cs in minus Cs at a certain time divided by Cs in minus Cs zero is equal to minus the volume flow rate divided by the volume multiplied by the time. And in principle, the solution of the problem is here. We have now to get out the concentration Cs, writing it in a different way, and then we can solve this this problem. If you substitute the values of the example, you get a final concentration Cs, which is 1.54 grams per liter. Okay, success.